Hi there. My name is Dimitris Haralabidis. I'm a math teacher, and in this video, we are going to see how we can divide fractions. Just like with whole numbers, we can apply the operation of division between any two fractions. This division can be done in two ways. The first way is by using reciprocals. And since we will use reciprocals, let's find out what a reciprocal actually is. By definition, we can say that given a random fraction a over b, its reciprocal will be the fraction b over a. We can see that all we need to do is turn the original fraction upside down, or in simple words, just flip it. For example, the reciprocal of the fraction 2 over 4 will be the fraction 4 over 2. In the question, what is the reciprocal of 5? All we need to think is that number 5 can be written in fraction form as 5 over 1. And therefore, it's easy for one to see that its reciprocal will be equal to 1 over 5. Have in mind, note, that it is easy to check whether two fractions are reciprocals. If they are, their product will always be equal to 1. For instance, is the fraction 6 over 7 reciprocal to the fraction 8 over 3? Although the answer is obvious enough, we will check it through the condition we just mentioned. I will simply multiply these two fractions, 6 over 7 times 8 over 3, and we know that when we multiply two fractions, all we need to do is multiply the numerators together and then multiply the denominators together. Therefore, the multiplication between these two given fractions will produce the fraction 48 over 21, which is, of course, different than 1. And since the result is different than 1, the two initial fractions cannot be reciprocals. We now know what a reciprocal is, but how can we use them to multiply fractions? Well, we can follow the rule below. A over b divided by c over d is equal to a over b times d over c, which is, of course, equal to a times d and all that over b times c. So all we need to do is simply flip the second fraction and then do the multiplication. For example, let's do together the division of 4 over 5 by 8 over 7. As we mentioned, all we're going to do is flip the second fraction. And therefore, we are going to write it as the multiplication of 4 over 5 by 7 over 8. And all this will produce the result, which will be equal to 28 over 40. Another example. Do the division of 4 by the fraction 3 over 4. Remember now that any whole number can be written in fraction form by simply putting number 1 in place of the denominator. With that said, we can rewrite number 4 as 4 over 1 and then divide this fraction, divide 4 over 1, by 3 over 4. And this division will be held by simply flipping the second fraction. And therefore, we will write 4 over 1 times 4 over 3, which will be equal to the product of the numerators, 4 times 4 equals 16, over the product of the denominators, 1 times 3 equals 3. Let's now see the second way of dividing fraction. This time, we will do it by creating a, let's call it, fraction of fractions. Assuming that we need to do the division of a over b over c over d, we can create a new fraction in the form we see in front of us. A over B and all that over C over D. which will be equal to A times D over B times C. So we can see that the extreme values, which are highlighted by yellow, will be multiplied together, and their product will go to the place of the numerator, while the middle values, which are highlighted by pink, will be multiplied together, and their product will move to the denominator respectively. For example, if we want to do the division of 4 over 3 by 2 over 6, as we mentioned, we will create a new fraction of fractions in the form 4 over 3 divided by 2 over 6, and then we will multiply the extreme values together, number 4 and 6, and this result, their product, will move in place of the numerator. 4 times 6 is equal to 24, while in the place of the denominator will go the product of the middle values, the product of numbers 3 and 2. Finally, the result to this division will be the fraction 24 over 6. For any questions you might have about this content we just saw, you can always leave a comment below the video, or you can simply contact me directly on my personal email. As always, thank you for your time.